out for something impossible, I need to borrow a $20 bill. This is when I usually lose eye contact with everybody. Job, 10, 5, receipt in jail. What do we got? What do we got, sir? Nothing. 20, 10, 5. Higher the bill, funnier the trick. More magical, more magical. Let's see. Oh, we got it. 20. Yeah. All right, here. Hold on to your bill. I'll pass you the marker, catch the marker, and write your name on it really big all over the face. Name, credit card number, expiration date. Those last three digits on the back. I need that for eBay. Awesome. Really exciting day for me today. I pass level 35 on Candy Crush. Word. That's right. Got your name on it? Cool. Toss the marker. Actually, pass it. And we pass the marker. This is going to freak you out. So do me a favor, hold out your hand flat like a table, just like this. I'm being really good today. I swear I'm being really good. All right, you can see the name on the bill. Dennis has committed what we like to call here in America a federal offense. You see the name on it, and you see the name on it. And do me a favor, squeeze real tight, just like this. Don't move. Excellent. We never met before. I didn't set this up before the show. Never met before. Cool. Seems psyched about that. Actually, a little bit higher in the air so people in the back can see. Awesome. Watch. Open your hand. Check it out. That would have been cool, though, huh?
Yay!
How's Dennis looking? Matt, I don't make eye contact now. It's a little awkward. Tell me when he leaves. Still there. I'm a giver. Okay. Don't worry. Your $10 is safe. We're going to do something else first. We'll do the optical illusion first, then we'll get back to your bill. Watch. At the end, I do something kind of gross. It's with a knife. So when I pull out the knife, pull out your camera, just in case I mess it up. There it is. Awesome. Small knife. All right, so knife is the ending. All right. Optical illusion. Long piece. Long piece. You donated. I like you. You're my favorite so far. medium piece. We'll use this later. Crispy good, and let's see, nothing personal. There you go, awesome. you'll grow into it. Sharpie, do me a favor, stretch out the rope, make sure it's not bungee cord, thank you. Run around and make it like a real crowd of people. Make sure it does not stretch anything like that. Now, bungee cord, really follow along, this is like a $20 value for you. It doesn't tug, anything like that. The ends aren't magnetic, really touch them together, not magnetic. I get that one all the time. You guys are kind of close together, touch them to each other, excellent. All right. I feel bad about the money thing. We're going to do the bill trick again. Give me another 20. stock joke, clean hand. I'm just kidding. We're going to do the optical illusion, and then we'll get back to his $5 bill. All right, long piece. Toss it up. El Toso La. There you go. Small piece. Toss it up. And chokey. Turn that all the way up. There you go. Right, three. Two pieces. Yeah, Jason will recover him, and he does all the Kevin James chairs and all of like Kevin's buildings. He always does really good stuff. Yeah, it's really cool. And I mean, if nothing else, there's a lot of times I'm not using it for the ring switch. Like Harry Anderson, when he came out with his act, he used to use a Legomatic chair and a doctor's bag, and he'd pop the chair. I think that's where he had the joke of, you know, kind of like the Michael Finney thing of that was 350, and that's all that does. And that's the doctor's bag. So yeah, they're really neat. I found it from Chris Hart. I watched his thing and I loved it. So. So I'm going to talk about a subject that I love. It's my passion right now. And then we'll do some, we're going to get right into my hit trick, basically. I'm going to do Inception right up front. It's what a lot of you came to see. So I don't know how late you guys are staying up. And Inception has so much to talk about that we're going to get to it immediately. So if this is the reason you tuned in, hello. So the Bill and Lemon trick is not the trick that I ever wanted to be known for. My dad was alive right now and could see all this. He would think it's hilarious because it was the first trick that he taught me, and I fought it forever because I wanted to be a bird act instead. And throughout the years, when I needed time, I always went back to the Bill and Lemon. And so my first Bill and Lemon was a serial number and erasing the last few digits and having them put the serial number up and then picking any orange and then just whatever vanished to the orange. Years later, I got rid of it. I read John Carney's Fruit Cup with tearing the corner. Awesome routine. Did that forever. Bought Yo Masika's thing. I started working on Steve Spill. I bought The Final Answer. I bought every Bill and Lemon on the market, and I just kept finding, for my situations on the street and the restaurants, there's a lot going wrong. I called my buddy, Scott Alexander, and I was having trouble with my restaurant set in general. I wasn't getting a lot of tips, and he was like, it's all about Bill and Lemon. And I wasn't getting tips with Bill and Lemon, and the two big things, number one, that he started me off with is, number one, please, all magicians, this is my bag, and this is Scott, I'm not going to speak for Scott, but, you know, he did this for me, too. Stop tearing corners and stop serial numbers. They're not fooling anybody. They're only fooling the performer doing them. I'm sorry to say that, and there's a lot of people out there going, I do the Barry Richardson and I kill with it. No, you don't. Because of a lot of things. I've never, when I pulled open the lemon, I've never had a spectator go, if that's missing the corner that I'm holding. No, they've never said that. They've never said, if my serial number matches. But they do say every time, if my name's on that thing. Oh, your name is such a personal thing. Like, we all had to go to school and figure out how to do our signature, and our teacher made us do it. I'm pretty sure there's, like, a paycheck involved in this thing, and I'm pretty sure they're going to sign it, and they're not going to tear the corner off or anything else. So signing checks and signing something is such a thing that we take so personally. We know our name. We know our signature. And not only that, I don't have to deal with torn corners backstage getting mixed up at the Magic Castle, let's say. I had three lemons and three corners, and the early performer didn't know and pushed the lemons out of the way and mixed up all my stuff. And now I had to reset everything. And it's an anticlimactic trick. When you have the bill and the lemon with a signature, the trick is open. It's over the minute I open the bill. It's an applause cue. It's powerful. It's not over with a torn corner or a serial number. The bill's open, and now we have to check the corner. And do you have the corner? Oh, you lost the corner again. Oh, God, you know. Is it match? And here's how it always sounds. I'm sorry. Does the corner match? Yeah. And there's your ending. Like, there's your ending. And this is my closing trick that I do at Ex-Burlesque at the Flamingo. It's my baby, and you can see it from the stage. The other thing, even worse, is the serial number. It's like, and the bill. Let's go to the board. 6, 9, 3, 5, 8, 9. That's long. Like, I could have did it. I'm already on to the rings by the time I've handed the bill back. Like, that's that long process. Procedure kills magic. It really does. John Carney taught me that, and I agree with it. Procedure kills magic. It really does. The act of picking a card and putting it back takes 10 seconds. Why certain tricks it takes 10 hours, I don't know. So, with the Bill and Lemon,
have it signed, number one. The reason you're not having it signed is you're very scared to load the bill in front of people. I've taken away the fear for you, so there we go. The other thing Scott taught me was the picking of lemons was very important. Very important. My day is spent picking lemons. I have every ex-girlfriend go, I never look at lemons the same again. I pick them up in the store and look at the bottoms. And, the bottom must be like an orange, very flat, kind of an indent in it. When it has kind of two nipples on both sides, where it would look like that, let's say, that would be a bad lemon. You want it to be very flat, like the bottom of an orange. Okay, because you're going to load it. I would really love to tell all you guys that this was, that I thought of this, and I didn't. Scott Alexander said the way to make a hole was to take and put a Sharpie in like this. I use a pen a lot. So he told me to put the Sharpie in, and that would make a hole for the bill and the lemon. Okay, I noticed that if I left the Sharpie in there, the hole would kind of stay a little longer. Scott likes to take it out so that way it reseals. I wanted to keep it open because I was getting new with the load. So I would set these up in my bag on the street, and just out of bad habit, I kept forgetting to pull the marker out. I kept forgetting. And a friend of mine named Adam Flowers looked at me and goes, that is genius. And I was like, what do you mean? And he goes, how you leave the marker in to orientate the hole. And I went, yeah, that is genius. I'm doing that on my lecture tour next week. It's called Inception. Thank you, Adam. And I literally went, he's right. And the next show, I was able to find the bill, put it in way faster than ever thought of. And this was born. The problem with the Bill and the Lemon is when Doc Eason and when Steve Spill created this version that Doc Eason later taught and became a very popular version, you have to go in at the end of the effect, find the bill, find the hole, load it, and pull out the lemon, all at your ending, at the moment when really the heat is on you. I'm a close-up magician who's also a stage magician, but I have equal brains. I do have a stage brain, and I do have a close-up brain. That's why some of my stage magic has John Carney influences on some of my illusions. You know, I'll do a sub-trunk with a John Carney idea, and I'll have, you know, close-up stuff that's influenced by Joaquin Ayala. So because of my influences being so crazy mixed. Having all this in here, let me see, lemon, oh, nice. All this is going to go in here. You're going to have, I use the professor's nightmare. This all goes in here. The lemon goes in there. The marker goes in there. The knife goes in there. The crown bag's in here. Whoosh, there you go. It's very self-contained. It's very nice. I bought the lemon game. It was very staged where I had to go behind stuff and on the street that didn't really work. This was very self-contained and surroundable. And all of the Bill and Lemons I'm talking about have their power in their place. Like, I think the Inception is great. I really, really do. I think for stage, I think Lemon Game is better. I think for walk around street, I think Inception is better. So, and I'll even show you a close-up walk around version I think is even better than this for like actual table hopping. So anyway, so this is all built in. It's all very practical. And so that gets set off to the side. I usually actually hang it from a mic stand on when I do the comedy clubs. I'll actually hang this from the mic stand so it's out there before I even walk out. Kind of has the feel that they had full view of it the whole time. Like I said, these little box fold-up things are fantastic. A big tip Adam Flowers gave me was the big red marker. These big red Sharpies are awesome. You can see the signature on the bill from the back of the house. If you take a black marker or a regular Sharpie, that kind of blends in with the green, and you don't see it. This was a big key to bringing this to the stage for me. So big, giant, red Sharpie. Thank you, Adam Flowers. Thumb tip, you're going to need. I use my little fifth pocket here for my thumb tip. I think that's what the fifth pocket was invented for. What else? So there you go. All right. And I put it by the markers when I'm grabbing them both. Bam. So you have marker, thumb tip, and self-contained everything. You borrow the bill. Do you have any kind of bill? 1, 5. It's still wet. That was dry. Cool. So, like I said, a lot of this, my influences on this are just packed together, from Richard Sanders to, like, just so many different kinds of things. Amazing Jonathan, Dan Harlan. Dan Harlan, when I was a kid, taught me to do the bill switch without a thumb tip. I remember that distinctly, with him teaching me without a thumb tip. And that saved me so many times when you forget your thumb tip and you don't want to do the vanish. I have a bill switch and I can go out and I can vanish the signature. I'll switch the bill instead of just making it disappear. This trick has so many outs and ways of doing it. I borrow the bill. I kind of like the vanish. I use a plastic thumb tip. I'm going to do, you're going to fold up the bill as you would in a bill switch. So in a bill switch, it's going to go left to right, up, left to right, and folding up. Through from behind. Give that a try. Left to right, up. Now here's what I added into the my little fold. I add one more little crease down the middle. This, it makes it like a little bullet. That bill is hard to get into a lemon. It's going to take some maneuvering and all that. If I just make that extra fold now, I'm already ready. So I just do a simple vanish of just placing the bill into the thumb tip. I go, it's gone, it's in your hand. And I just keep a very loose attitude with my hands. You know, I've even had people say, oh, it's a fake thumb. I've had it, and I have a really great out for that. It's awesome. It's my favorite part is actually getting busted. I love it. So good. So it's gone. Yay. And I do the joke. I will hold out as long as possible on this guy. I'll on Fremont actually try to get him to leave, actually. I'll read the sign behind me. I'll be like, Dunkin' Donuts. Steak and eggs. Are you still there? All right. He's resilient. All right. This is kind of neat, with the way the effect works. So the bill is gone. Now with the crown bag and the opening, I can just take my thumb, place it inside, and as I open the bag, give me a little twist with this. As I open the bag, I'm gonna let the thumb tip fall. This is so weird, too slow. And now let this drop second. So you just want to separate the tip and the bill. So now, I often do the Lifesaver Saw by Sean Fields. I do that early in my act, and I tell them that I'm going to do something gross again. So when I go in for the knife, I'm looking for just the thumb tip. I grab the thumb tip, I put it on my thumb, and I grab the knife all in the same motion. If it takes a second, I don't care if the thumb tip's backwards or whatever. I'm just trying to find the thumb tip and the knife at the same time. Okay. If it takes a second, you know, there's a lot of jokes, a little to the left, oh, that's a spot, yeah. I actually start the introduction of, at the end, I'm going to be doing something with a knife, so when I get out the knife, get out your cameras, iPhone, BlackBerry, blah, blah, blah. And I take the knife. Man, I'm being really good today. I've cut, like, so many comedy jokes. I am, like, not really myself right now, to be honest.
Now, Chris, honestly, you don't be quite that good. You can still
I know.
Some of the street stuff in.
I know, because the stuff
you've said so far is
no,
funny.
No, trust me. You can attest. I'm editing pretty good right now. I'm editing really good right now. So I'm learning after my lunch with Lance to be very family friendly. So,
well, it depends on whose family you're performing to.
Yeah. I'll tell you. It's a good one. I like it. Not the pink pool yet. All right. So the knife goes away with the thumb tip right here. Now you're clean. You've got all that, you know, away. So this is, I think, the part of the load that freaked people out for years was, and it freaked me out when I even, you know, when Carney was in the audience and I had to load the bill in front of John Carney, I freaked out. I never wanted to feel that again, ever. I got off stage and was like, that's never happening again. And so with tossing everything out to them, puts all the focus on them. So it's medium piece, always goes to a girl. I do a lot of adult humor about choking women. And so that goes to her. The long piece will go to the guy who gave me the bill. I used to give him the small piece and pick on him the most, but he's the one I really want the money out of. And I did date a stripper for a while, and it was one of the smartest things and dumbest things I've ever done in my entire life. But one of the smartest things was the teaching of dynamics of people. And I want to look for an alpha male, like, pop-up going to drop that kind of money. He'll actually leave the money with me. I'm really good about picking who the guy is, learning about alpha and beta and all that. I know Nick hates hearing about this part. But, like, I know who's going to drop the 100 and who's going to drop the 20. And, you know, there's some people in the audience who've seen me on Fremont who can tell you I get it almost 9 times out of 10 because it's the picking of the guy. And that was dating a stripper. So that was there. You don't really date a stripper. You rent him longer. Okay, so so now all the ropes are out to them. Okay, everyone always freaks out, you know, with the load. So with everything being small piece, and then small piece always goes to any. Basically, if it's the first person I ask who maybe doesn't have money, and then when I throw them the small piece, they'll bring money next time. Okay. So now what I have in the bag is I have the marker, the lemon, and the bill floating around in here. So if I look inside before I go for the whole marker joke, what I'm doing is I'm looking, I'm finding the bill, I'm squeezing it against the side of the lemon. So now I have the bill right here. I can see the hole, and because of the marker, I know the orientation of the hole. So when I pull it out, and I do the Sharpie joke. I go, Sharpie, awful joke, I know that. You know, all this is gonna relax. Now I kind of go to the guy whose money it is, and I go, actually stretch out the rope. And as I start saying that, I'm just stretching out the rope, or stretching out the bag as I'm following along. I stretch out the rope, stretch out the rope. Here, follow along. This is like a $20 value. As my hands come together, in the bag like this. As soon as so I'll go stretch, stretch, and as my hands come together, value. As soon as it's a little in, I'm back out. Because through the bag, I can push this in there. So you'll always see me through the bag pushing. I just need a little of it in there. So now what's nice is when I'm going to stretch out the rope, I just forget about this. I give this no attention. Stretch out the rope. Actually, in YouTube, they don't even hear the lemon drop. I'm amazed how many times I get a response out of the production of the lemon. Like, I get a, like, 8-bag response all the time where they're like, whoa! I'm like, so this is on the ground. Sometimes I'll hang it up on the mic stand. There's some really funny bits with talking and all that. So now the rope is all on them. Like, all the heat is here. What's great about that is, because I've given you the orientation of the hole, you know where the bill is, and you've got all the heat over here. When I had a moment with John Carney sitting in the audience, I don't have to have that. If I have a moment for a second, I have stretch on the rope, stretch on the rope, stretch on the rope, stretch on the rope. Hey, stretch on the rope, stretch on the rope, stretch on the rope, jokey, 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 jokey. I'm still not loaded, so I'm going to move on to you now. I have so much time to actually load the bill, okay? Now that when I've loaded it and the attention's all on them, I have a 3-minute rope routine and time delay for them to forget that this bag was ever in play. And I love, as a close-up magician, we were taught to take, you know, do the pass and then set the deck down and then don't touch it for a while. Don't do the pass as you do the trick. And I felt with this, we were doing the pass as we were doing the trick. We were showing the method and the trick at the same time. And here we're separating it so far, and we'll show you something else with that in a second. So now we're just going to do fiber optics. I don't have any work on any of this, really. It's just fiber optics, I think. So it's a long piece. And this is just all... most of the magic that I chose, other magic, do stuff, new place that I just kind of got me. I try to let the Roger Sanders a lot of the rep. And the end, it's like that. Do Danny Garcia's pressure, get at the center tip, the marker, behind your back. So you are forgetting about your one hand or the pet. 30 minutes of loading. I know a lot of people hand out balloons. Things fall back to its normal. I'm holding on to a medium, a small, and a long. That's small. That's medium. That's the long. Okay. So now he doesn't have to be the rope routine. I know a lot of people hand out balloons and do Danny Garcia's pressure. Deck of cards is awesome right here. As we all know, if we hand a layman a deck of cards and go, here, shuffle, you got 30 minutes to load the bill at that point. I've done it. One of my favorite things is I wasn't good at the center tear. So what I would do is, this is kind of fun,
center tear. Okay, so yeah, so you have the bill, the marker, and a pad of paper. So you pull out the pad of paper first, and you hand her the pad of paper. You pull out the marker, and you hand her the marker. And you go, I don't even want to look at your work. And you just turn around and load the bill right behind your back. So you say, I don't want to see it, anything like that. And you just turn around and you load the bill. Now when you come back with the crown bag, I can use a lot of bits where I go, you are getting sleepy. You are forgetting about your money. You're a good tipper. Or I would lead into the center tear now. This is when she was thinking about her word. Think about your word, you know. And then I was able to get the center tear. With a deck of cards, you can pull, you can have the marker in there. You pull the marker out. You have her take out a card, sign her name on it. By that time, you've loaded this. It doesn't have to be ropes. But pull something else out of the bag afterwards. Give them something to do. Load the bill and then move back into the trick. So after the ropes is done, that's like 3 minutes. They really forgot about a lot of the sequencing and the procedure that happened beforehand. So that's why I go to the knife. I pull out the knife. I show my eye. This is something from a guy in Vegas I saw years ago, David Kesterson. He would do this with razor blades and freak people out. And I was like, he stops performing. I'm taking that. And so I always go to put it up to my eye. The audience freaks out. I'm just kidding. Finally liked my act for a second, you know. The guy who I was kind of picking with, I'll always go like, oh, he finally liked me. Darn. Put the knife in my mouth. And now I pick up a bag. I swing it. And now when I'm reaching in, I just want to put my thumb over the hole. A lot of the stuff I'm going to now do, Layman said to me later on when you're actually talking through the routine. There's a lot of methods that people think with this. So they think something's on the knife. So I kind of make it clear nothing's on the knife, nothing's in my hands. They think that the first cut isn't the first cut. So I try to say sometimes if it's a talking situation, look, that's the first cut ever done. I make sure to show it all, my hand completely empty. Okay, cut, 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 cut. Here's what's kind of cool that happens to me 9 times out of 10. When you split the lemon, I leave it like a little hinge, and hopefully the bill will go off into this half and leave this half. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Nah, it didn't that time. Nah, it didn't that time. When it goes into the other half, which is really cool, like I said, it's half and half. It's kind of your bonus. When it comes off into the other half, the part with the hole, I get rid of immediately. I dump that out, and I even now say, look, no holes, no breaks, no openings, nothing like that. And the coolest ending is now when I go to the guy or whoever's bill it is, I go, look, and I make sure to say I don't switch or I let them pull it out because a lot of people thought I switched it. Some people thought the knife put it in there. I've heard everything. I had a lady say, you can keep the 20 if I can pull it out. And I was like, there you go. Even that, and that meant something to her. Like, if she saw Dynamo on TV, she thought he switched it then. She goes, but she was recalling it and she goes, I always thought if I could have done it, and I went, oh, there you go. If it happens to be in the half of the hole, that's fine. That's why you're just dumping it. I also, a lot of people thought they were plastic lemons. That's why I squeeze and get juice all over the place. I also want to soak up the bill so he really doesn't want it. If it is a guy in a nice suit and he has a nice watch on, it is Big Papa. He doesn't want the 20 back, and he kind of wants to impress the date or impress the people around him that he's got the money and all that. I want him to impress them. So he opened up the bill. When I fold the bill, I try to leave somewhat of a lip because on stage, especially with the lights and music and nerves, and it could be hard to open up the bill to the music and have it on the cue. So I do leave little lips on it for me. And now when you open it, because of that red marker, bam, you see that miles away. Back of the house, you can see that. I mean, you still see the red. You know? That's the weird lighting. If it's obviously a black marker, it's going to start to blend in. Any other color, it's not going to blend in. If it's not the really, really thick one, it's not going to stand out as much. This is a dryer, Dennis. Thank you. The Bill and Lemon is, I think, is by far one of the strongest tricks out there in magic. It has paid my rent repeatedly. Last 5 years, my hips went from $80 a night to $300 a night. everybody was coming to find me for that trick. Scott talks about this. For some reason, the lemon is funny. An orange and a lime is not. You can, if you're running through, on a cruise ship or something like that, it is easier to find an orange than a lemon. You don't want to be a pain and be going to the bar, like, drinking a lemon and go through all of them and look at the bottoms of them and all that. It's really easy to go by the buffet line, grab an orange, and that was just as good as the flat bottom that you need in a pinch. Limes were really good. If you find a lemon that isn't very good, you can cut off the bottom of it. I've just flat out cut off the bottom, put my thumb over it, especially for stage. Really cheat your angles this way. I don't know why this trick has done like so much for me in the last like 2 years, but I've had a career because of this stupid trick. And especially now I've started to like tag their bills on Instagram, and you guys are having Danceberry, I think, later in the year, the social media thing. It talks about like I created Instagram just for the bill so that I say to people, if you drop the bill in, you can go on my Facebook, see that you've donated to the cause of my career. And, if I'm on Fremont Street, I have to kind of make a distinction between me and the homeless guy next to me, because they go, oh, you kind of have to educate them that this is street theater. They have to pay at the end. This is actually a job. I'm not just trying to, like, scrape together some money. This is an actual job I'm paying bills with. I educate them with that. And, Bill Lemon, I really do owe a lot of this to Scott Alexander and Adam Flowers and my dad. He actually would have loved the serial number crap if I didn't like that. So in the idea of in this, I talked about, and Dan talked about in the video intro and all that. In the idea of the time delay, I'm going to talk about something now that I've never talked about, and something that a few people in Vegas are very excited that I've come out with this idea. The Master Prediction Chest is the Doug Malloy, Diana Zimmerman, or Dick Zimmerman.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. And just before you get into it, just let me interject just very quickly. Yes. Just to let you know that Scott Alexander is tuning in.
Ah!
So you can say hey, right. And
saw that one coming.
Yeah.
Give me that joke.
But we're all excited to hear how you can, how you can mix this time delay idea with the master prediction system. I want to know this.
Okay.
In particular. Yeah.
So because of Doug's prop being very expensive, I know because I bought him and rented him and all that. There's me. So I can't expose a lot of the actual prop. But if you own the prop, we're going to talk about some things. So it's the box. So it's production box. It hangs the whole show. Comes down onto a table or step stool. The box is open. There's a tube inside, and inside is a prediction.
Не мешай мне снимать. Твой голос в интернет попадет, иди.
The thing I feel with the master prediction chest, the method is happening when the box is coming down. Something happens. Kid with the pink shirt, make a description of each person. The box comes down with a tube. I go inside the tube is a piece of paper and a deck of cards.